have an idea how we can use Nearpod and many activities through Nearpod, and we are going to use many interactive like what all we can do with these technologies, different links which you I will share through this Nearpod. So please join the link. Okay, I hope everybody will join. All are joining. I'm just waiting for a few more seconds and then I will start. Please join the link which I have shared in the chat. Okay, so now here, this is given by our Sharjah Education, Private Education Authority. And when we have started, I just want to share this slide with you. They says that innovation is linked to the 21st century skill, and mainly it is three learning skills, literacy skills, and life skills. These three skills together includes the innovation and 21st century skills. So although you all know already, you all are teaching and you already know about it, just quickly, I will just, as Vinny ma'am said, it's a critical thinking is the first thing for 21st century skill. Next is creativity, collaboration, and communication. Literacy skill include information, media, and technology. And the last is life skill, which is very, very important, which includes flexibility, leadership, initiative, productivity, and social skills. So these skills should be there when we are planning for our lessons. We have to enhance these skills. So when we start, we always say that 4C, we should never forget, that children should learn how to communicate, that we should have the collaboration activities, critical thinking, and creativity. So whatever we are using in our class, we will use keep 4C in our mind. Then why we need this innovation, why we should use it? The answer is that we student need to learn how to process and analyze information rather than simply commit it to memory. Student need to learn how to apply facts and ideas. They should know how to do it. And student need to be able to communicate and collaborate effectively in digital world. So these are why we need innovation. These are the three main reasons. So
ma'am, can now, you share the previous slide?
Yes, previous slide, yeah. Yeah. Okay. Now, shall I move to the next one?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, these were the why we need the 21st century skill. That was the reason. So we all have to be innovative teacher. That is for sure. We all have to include the something which include innovation. Now, this is this is a collaborative board which I am using now. Please, all of you have to answer this. Why do teachers take risk in the class? And how is it connected to innovative teaching and learning? I'm just showing you that when we start, please look carefully how I'm taking this session. In the same way, you can take the class. In the same way. When we are starting the lesson, we always pose a question which will make everybody think. So that's the question which I have taken here. So I want, please, somebody just think and give the answer. Why do teachers take risk and how is it connected to innovative teaching? At least one word you should all, any one of you, please write. So I just want to show you here how the answer will appear on the your screen. All the students will give the answers here and you can see the answers on your screen. So let me just refresh if anybody has given the answer. I will just refresh that. To have fun. Yes, very true. We take the risk to have fun so that children also feel light. That's very true. Good. To make students risk takers. Yes, very true. We are the role models in front of the students. Very true. Thank you for giving the answers. Teacher need to encourage the student to respond and learn effectively. Yes, very true. To inspire them. Very true. So we are learning so many different new tools, and we are checking in the class. We are taking so many risks, and we take the risk, and we are well confident enough that if one will not work, we have the backup plan always ready with us. So that much confident we all are there. So whenever you start your lesson for the innovative teaching, first of always give one thinking question, which will make them think why I should do this. Okay. So, and it will also tell us what is their previous knowledge, and we will connect to the lesson. Then our next thing come, what is the learning objective? This is really very important. It means why the learning objective is important. Whenever the SLT members are also coming in your class, the first thing they want to see whether the objectives are achieved or not. That is what they are searching during the lesson when they are observing you. Even when you are teaching, we are coming with some objective. We are spending our such a beautiful weekend here, and we are spending our evening with some purpose, isn't it? So what's that objective? So anyway, I just showed that objective just to tell you, you already know it. So whenever we start our class, we give the thinking question, and then second, we write the objective. But so now here for this session, I just told that you will able to identify few tools, different tools, which you can use it in our daily classroom. Whenever you frame the learning objective, I hope you all are aware of Bloom taxonomy, which we are using it. Also, the learning objective should be very brief, clear, and very specific statement should be there. And just I want to give one suggestion, that put learning objective on every slide what you are presenting. You know, some children are joining little late, so they will have an idea that what will be there. Now let's get started to these tools. So let's start the journey here. Now this is a collaborative board in Nearpod. Now where when I'm starting, I will just ask the, I have given a question, what was the last risk you took in your class? So just think and just write at least few words. What was the last risk you took in your class? I'm waiting for the answer, please. Just, I want somebody to give the answer. What was the last risk you took in your class? I want to show you. Thank you. So, someone has used breakout room. Yeah, that is really complete risk. I did two, three times. I made blunders in that. And then I came to know how to come out. I was jumping from one room to another. Then I don't know how to end the breakout room. And really we do experiments, then we learn. That's very good. Playing online game together. That's true. And children are very fast in playing online game. We are very much behind for these things. Very true. Applied peer deck. Yes. A peer deck also, when you are giving the prompt, we are just holding our heart that how it is going to be. Because sometimes that prompt doesn't appear. So it's taking time to load. So our heart is sinking to how it is going to do. So these all the risks we are taking, and that then we are applying the innovation. That's very true. So this is a collaborative board. Why I ask you to write this? This is a collaborative board. So you can also ask your children when you are starting the lesson, how you are feeling today, and whatever topic you are taking, ask any question and give this collaborative board. So all the answers will appear. So the tools which I will show you now, in that, this is one of your collaborative board, which is, I think, those who are using the Padlet, they know. It is same, almost same like Padlet, but it is there in Nearpod. Just observe that. So let's move to the next one. So these are the quickly, I will just take these tools, although I know many of you are aware of it, but those who have still not explored, please explore these tools. It's a peer deck, Padlet, Thinkling, Quizzes, Kahoot, Breakout Room, Flipgrid, Canva, Wheels of Name, and Lucidapp. quickly I'm going through this, and Nearpod, I'm already using it. Please observe that how I'm using the Nearpod. You can use it in your classroom. So let's move to the here. First one, I have taken the PeerDeck. PeerDeck is a very good, good collaborative tool, and it is, you can show your interactive presentation. And I just tell you, when my classes have started, the internet speed in the school was very slow because we are going to the school. So when all the teachers are taking the classes, I mean, if one teacher is having one free period, the speed is good. But when all teachers are taking classes, there the speed is slow. So when I started the classes, I was just holding my head that time is taking so much. How should I do? But I mean, when I am changing my slide, children are saying the screen is black, ma'am. They can't see the screen because my speed is slow. So this is a very good PeerDeck, and Nearpod is very good solution for it. When your speed is slow, you can give the way I have given you the link. You can see the presentation on with your own speed. You don't have to rely on me, my speed. So this is a PeerDeck is an interactive presentation tool where you can engage the students in individual and as well as social learning. So I just want to quickly show the example of it. Here also, the same thing, what you can do in PeerDeck, the same thing you can do in Nearpod also. The children will, you can give them some, suppose you have given them some problem, they will solve. And the main thing in PeerDeck is that children will not able to see each other answer. So whatever question we will ask them, they cannot see answers of others. So this is the question I gave. It's a grade 3 word mass word problem. A bus carries 56 passengers in one trip. I given them problem. They have written the answer, and they have written down their name and date and class. This was a grade 3 small children. So in this way, I can show the answers on the screen, but children will able to, they can't see each other's answers. So they are working on their own pace. And they just write, this is the girl, Khushi. She has written the date on the side. And she has also written her passion about the math, you know. And I just love this because in PeerDeck and Nearpod, I used to tell children, whatever you are solving, you solve it. Down you write if you want to give any message. So generally, whatever they don't want to speak in the class, they write it down. Ma'am, I'm feeling very lazy today. I slept very late. So when you, whatever they want to say, ma'am, this girl is sometime really irritating in the class. Can you tell her to be quiet? I want to solve my problem. So, I mean, whatever message they don't want to speak in the class, they don't want to give direct message or they give it here in the PeerDeck also. So whatever they want to express. So that was some children, they just write the answer. These are the small children. So, I will just go back to my wait. We were here. It will take time to slide load. So we were there on the PeerDeck. Let's quickly move to the next one. Next tool is Padlet, which you already are aware of it. If any one of you have not explored the Padlet, please do it. It is such a beautiful platform where children express themselves, they express their feelings, and they can use use different links. I just want to show you an example of the Padlet. This is a grade 5 girl. These are the grade 5A children, and last year I gave them that write your wish, my wish for 2021. What is your wish? So I told them to express on this platform. So it is a good virtual bulletin board, or you can say a wall, where student and teachers both can collaborate, they can reflect, they share the links and pictures in secure location. So they have given the all the different, some have given the voice message, and I hope you will able to listen. I just want to share this this one girl has shown a message. I don't want to tell her name, so I have written anonymous there. We can add it after the children have written. We can add it in there. Just listen to it.
Hello, my name is Mariam. My Second wish is that my father's job could change and he could get an easy job which can help, which he will get enough money and enough time to spend with holidays and all. My third.
She is telling about the father job, that father's my father should get some good job. See what we all are facing with the salary cut and the how the families are facing with the different financial problems. It all the children express in the class. Whenever you give them a small chance, no, they just express, ma'am, I want my father to get the job back. Ma'am, I want my father to play with me. He is very sad nowadays. So it really reflects. And even they are missing the friends also. That is also there. So when we play, you know, when we give them such platform where they speak, they tell what they are missing. So we should give them a platform. See, here one girl is there, Azra. I think she is just.
I want my best friends to always be near me, and whenever they are feeling hurt, I will always help them.
So these are the way we can give them the platform where they can express themselves. And this was the Padlet. I hope all are, I know many of you are already have the paid version of it also. All our paid version is very cheap of Padlet. But if you have not explored, please use this platform. It's a very beautiful platform. The third tool is ThingLink. ThingLink is the very user friendly, which provide user with the ability to turn any image into an interactive graphic. Like you can create a hotspot on specific parts of an image and turn that image to multimedia launcher. I will just quickly show you one example of it. Just give me a minute. This is an example where she is doing the yoga, and these are the example where the links are there. See, this is the example where Hindi words teacher is explaining the Hindi words.
And ma'am, we cannot see your screen.
You cannot see? Okay, just wait. I will share again. Just give me a second. I'm just sharing again. See, this is an example. Ma'am, you can see now. Okay. This is an example of turtle where the turtle, we have put the links on this image. So we made this image as a multimedia launcher. So here is a YouTube link. If you will click on it, you will watch a YouTube. Here is the resources link, whatever we want children to read and read about it. Here is the Padlet link. If I will click on it, Neena ma'am, you can see the Padlet now. Yeah, so it's a Padlet link. So children can immediately go to the Padlet and write their views. So this is the way we can use the ThingLink. And I will just come back to the Neena pal. Just give me a minute. So that was all about the ThingLink. Let's quickly move to the next one. Next tool is Quizzes. Quizzes, I hope everybody is using. Quizzes is an online tool that allows teachers to conduct student-based formative assessment in a fun and engaging manner. So, and it is for all students, for all ages. And I hope everybody is using that. If you have not explored, please explore it, because I feel it is like a blessing to all the teachers, because all ready-made quizzes is there. Whatever topic you, even I was, today I was typing topic quizzes, teaching and learning. So those who are there in giving for the some teaching exam and all, if you will go there, teaching strategies, teaching tools, so many quizzes are there on that platform. Not only that, all subject, every grade quizzes are there. So this quizzes is really a blessing for all the I should say all the teacher community, please, if you have not explored, please must explore it. Okay, that is for the quizzes. The next, it is a game-based learning. Sorry, it's taking time to load. Yeah, that's the Kahoot. Kahoot is also a game-based learning where students are, it also has a library where ready-made quizzes are there. And here in questions are projected on share screen in Kahoot. And when you, questions are there and players are can give the answer with their smartphone and with their laptops, but the questions will be projected on the screen if we are doing the live quiz in Kahoot. So that was Kahoot. So these were the five tools. Now see, this was the sample for the, because generally it comes in the four colors. They ask the answer in four colors when we play a live quiz. This is the example for Kahoot. Now see, I took few topic, how I'm taking the lesson. I started with collaborative activity. And if you will just go through my all slides at the back, every slide I have written the topic and learning objective. This is the way you should do it. You know, anybody, any child who is entering late in the class, any SLT member who is coming and checking your lesson, they turn up anytime. Topic and LO should be there on your slide, you know, because they should know what is going on. They that should be there. And children, some children are not very, very good observers. They take time to observe. We have to give that time, like Winnie ma'am was saying, 30 second pause should be there. So that topic and LO should be written on every slide. If you have seen my last slide, every slide I have written topic and learning objective. What's the learning objective and topic? That should be very much clear to the students. So in this way, we have to make our lesson. And now see, I have taken few things. Now I have given an activity. This is a draw activity in Nearpod, in which just it is an small example. In what areas of life are you likely to take risk? In what areas of life you least likely to take risk? Draw or describe in the chart below. Can you just try make a small things here, just so that I can just show it here. So in this way, you can give a draw question to children in between. So that whatever you are telling, I've just taken, I don't know, I just took like a random question, but you can just draw something that just that you are engaged. Even you can put a small tick also, that is also fine. Thank you. Some are doing it. So in this way, we can show everybody names comes here. Everybody names comes here and we can show or with the name, we can project it here on the screen that what is how they are doing it. And I always use the Nearpod because I make sure that all students are engaged. Now here, how many participants are there in my class? I just check here, if you can see on the side that 12 is coming. So I know that 12 students have joined my Nearpod. So 12 students, all the answers will be displayed here, how they are doing it. So you can help the child who is not able to do it. So thank you for making it here. That smiley also, I loved it. Thank you very much. So that's a good one. So this is the way we can take the, this is the draw activity in Nearpod. Just it was to give you an idea. Next, breakout room. Yes, breakout room is really a very good for making, for to split the meeting into smaller groups and to do the group activity. And we give them a close area and secure area for students where they can work together in the groups. And then they will come back and they make the presentation together and they come back. So this is also a very good tool. The next tool is Flipgrid. Flipgrid allows the teachers to create a grid to facilitate the video discussion. Here, teacher can post their question in video form, which is called the topic cell. And the student can post their video responses that appear in a tiled grid here. Tiled grid display. This is also very good tool because nowadays, as children are really not able to see their friends. And I just tell you my experience. I did one time, you know, so students are say only seeing through Zoom, right? So they just see the half part of it. And when on Flipgrid, when they are uploading the video, they are showing their dance, some are showing their this. So they have uploaded their video. Next day, there was a full discussion. My God, they were, one girl was asking to other girl, you have lost so much weight. What happened? I saw you on Flipgrid yesterday. So they were so excited. And they were saying, I really love the way you were doing it, from where you have learned this. So they were asking each other, so excited and happy to see each other through Flipgrid. So this is also a very good platform. I think if teachers, if you have not explored it, please explore and give children a chance to upload their videos here. So, and wish the students love to see each other. The next tool is Canva. Canva is a really a beautiful tool where from brainstorm and worksheet to presentation and posters, the whole class can design on it. So this is a very good tool, especially the elements and the beautiful beautiful pictures are there, and beautiful backgrounds are, ready-made backgrounds are there. So this is also a very good tool. You can make your presentation here. Wheel of Names is very good. Is a random made random selector tool which was designed for choosing names of the names or for choosing the winners. So I will just show you an example that Wheel of Name has really made my class very disciplined. You know, before that, as soon as I will pose any question, they, you know, they keep on asking, ma'am, I want to give the answer. Ma'am, you are not selecting me. I already asked you. I have last time also you didn't select me. So when you ask these type of any question, I will just share my screen here. You can put your class list here on the side. And Neena ma'am, my screen is visible? Yes? Okay, fine. So here you can just put your the class list here, and you can just spin here. When you will spin, you can see the noise here. I just check whether I hope I have. Ma'am, voice is there. I don't remember I shared song. Okay. So this is the way, and you can use in different way. You can make use for the multiplication tables also. You can put the table, ask any child, take the name and tell them to tell the table of this. So whatever will come here. So he has to answer 9 multiplied by 3, 9 3 7. So in this way, or they can write the question. Let me go back to my earboard. So in this way, we can use the Wheel of Names. I'm just going back to my earboard. Just give me a second. Okay. So Wheel of Name, here is also one example where why is cyberbullying a serious issue? You can write a question here and you can spin it, or you can give it in the group, or you can just give it as an individual activity. So questions, you can use it. The last tool is a Lucid tool. Lucid tool is a mind mapping tool where you can make your mind maps in the last, always give, whenever you summarize your lesson, use the mind map tool. So this Lucid is such a good mind map tool. And these all the 10 tools which I have covered, I will, the meeting is going to end. When we will come back, I will share that PDF with you, in which all the links also, please kindly note that whatever I have put it in the PDF, nothing is created by me. It is all my research work from the Google. The best articles I took, how to use this these tools effectively. And what are the, somewhere it is 30 ways to use the Padlet. We are not aware of it. So I just choose which are the good articles I have just inserted in that. So when you will come back after the meeting, it is less than 1 minute, then I will just share that PDF with you. And this is the last Nearpod which we are using it. So I think it's now less than 1 minute better. We will exit, Neena ma'am. So because I will start anything. Okay, yes. This is the PDF. Yeah, this is the PDF viewer. It is there in the Nearpod. PDF viewer is one activity in the Nearpod where you can put one PDF and you can show it in the class.
Thank you, ma'am. Raji ma'am, it's awesome presentation. We really enjoyed it. So we'll log on with the second meeting and then you can share all this information. Thank you, ma'am. Yeah.
Thank you.
We'll just log in again.
Yeah.